Good morning, students. Hope you are all safe and fine. Today we will discuss about the function of your chapter 1. You are familiar about the term function because you have already got these things in your HSLC first year course. Here you have learned what is a function and what are the types of a function, right? There is our signum function, constant function, then identity function, modulus function, greatest integer function. In this chapter, we will see some other types of functions. So here, in today's lecture, we will discuss about the some types of function and some examples of functions. First one is our 1-1 function. 1-1 function, by name it is clear that if 1 goes to 1, right? If f is a function from a to b, what is your a and b? A and b are two non-empty sets. Then f is said to be an 1-1 function if the image of distinct elements are distinct. Here in this diagram we have shown that is capital A contains the elements a, b, c, and capital B contains the element x, y, z. X is the image of A, y is the image of B, and z is the image of C under the function f. Now you see here A and B are different element, their images x and y are also different element. So in this diagram, if the elements are different, then their images are also different. So in that case, this is an example of an 1-1 function. Our next one is our many-one function. Many one function means there is many goes to one. If we find there is more than one element in the domain whose images are same, then we can call this function as a many one function. So in the second diagram you see here the x is the image of A, but y is the image of B as well as C. The image of B is also y and C is also y. So this is an example of an whatever function, this is an example of a many one function, that is, it is not an 1-1 function. Next one is your onto function. Onto function means that is, if every element in the codomain is the image of some elements of its domain, that is, there is no element left in the codomain which is not an image of any elements of the domain of a function, then this function is said to be an onto function. Now you see here A is the x is the image of A, y is the image of B, and z is the image of C. There is no other elements left in the B which is not an image of any elements of A. So this is an example of an whatever function, onto function. Next one is our into function. Into function means if there exists an element in the codomain which is not an image of any element of the domain. In that case, this function is said to be an into function. Now you see here in this diagram, the elements z left in the codomain B, which is not an image of any element of the domain A. So this is, in that case, this is the diagram of an into function. So we have seen what is our 1-1 function, what is many one function, what is onto function, and what is into function. Now, if a function is 1-1 only, then this function is known as injective function. If a function is onto only, this is known as your surjective function. And if a function is both 1-1 and onto, it is known as a bijective function. So here are some examples of a function. Let's see the examples. Example number 1, here let A be the set whose elements are r minus 3, that is, the A is the set of real number except 3, and B is the set of real numbers except 1, and f is a function from A to B. Then defined as fx is equal to x minus 2 by x minus 3, we have to show that whether our function is bijective or not. Now first of all, here f is a function from A to B, defined as fx is equal to x minus 2 by x minus 3. Now you see, whenever a function is given to us, our first part is to, we have to check whether our given function is defined on the domain or not. Now you see here, what is your domain here? Domain is nothing but your A. and this function fx is undefined when x is equal to 3, because when x is equal to 3 our denominator should comes out as 0, and when the denominator of a function is 0, then function is here undefined. But in your set A is nothing but here, that is R minus 3, that is we have to omit 3 from the set of real numbers. So x can since x belongs to A, therefore x can never be equal to 3, therefore this function fx will be never undefined. So we can say that our function fx is defined on the given domain A. So this is our first part. Now check the 1-1-1-2 property or not. First one, so what is our 1-1 property? How can you check the 1-1 property? You just remember the procedure. For checking 1-1 property, we have to consider any two elements of a domain such that their images are equal. Right? Any two elements in the domain such that their images are equal under that function. If we can show that points are equal, elements are equal, then our proof is over. That is, we can say that f is 1-1. So I am considering here two elements x1 and x2 of your domain A such that their images are equal. Images means f of x1 is equal to f of x2. Now here we can write fx is given to us, so f of x1 is nothing but your x1 minus 2 by x1 minus 3 is equal to x2 minus 2 by x2 minus 3. On simplifying these equations, we got here, because your x1, x2, x1, x2 cancel with each other, 6, 6 cancel with each other, we can show that x1 is equal to x2. That is, the images are equal, I have considered earlier, and here we have shown that the elements are equal. Therefore, f is nothing but your 1-1 function. Now come to the onto properties. For checking the onto property of a function, what is our procedure? Our procedure is we have to consider any element from the codomain. I am considering here y. Let y belongs to your codomain B such that f of x equal to y. We don't know about the element x. If we can show that our x belongs to domain, then f is 1-1. Right? So I am treating here y belongs to BB, any element such that fx is equal to y. Fx is given to us, fx is nothing but your x minus 2 by x minus 3. So here y in terms of x, that is y is equal to x minus 2 by x minus 3. Our first part is we have to convert x in terms of y. So what is your x? On simplifying, we will get x is equal to 3y minus 2 by y minus 1. Now you see whether our function x is defined or not. Now you see here, this function, function is your fx. Now you see here, this x is equal to 3y minus 2 by 1 y minus 1 is undefined when y is equal to 1. But here in the codomain, what is your y? Y, we have chosen here y from B. And what is your b? B is nothing but your r minus 1. That is, y can never be equal to 1. Therefore, these terms are defined. Now you see here, we have to show that x belongs to A. But we can say from this line, we can say that x is nothing but your real number. Right? Now, if x is equal to A is r minus 3, but if x is equal to 3, then what happen? Whenever we call cross multiply, 3y minus 3 equal to 3y minus 2. So by simplifying, we will get 3 is equal to 2, which is absurd, because 3 is not equal to 2. So we can say that x can never be equal to 3. X will be the all real numbers, but it never be equal to, can be equal to 3. Therefore, x belongs to A. So if I summarize all these things, that is, for every y belongs to B, there exists an x belongs to A such that fx is equal to y. So we can say that f is onto. Therefore, earlier we have shown that it is 1-1, now it is onto. So 1-1 plus onto means f is bijective. So this is an example of a bijective function. Now come to the second example. Your second example says that f is a function from n to n. N means the set of natural number defined as fn is equal to n plus 1 by 2 if n is odd, and it is n by 2 if n is even. We have to check its type. Now first of all, I am checking at 1-1 property. Now you see here, f of 3, what is your 3? 3 is an odd number. So f of 3 will be 3 plus 1 divided by 2 means 4 divided by 2. By cancelling, it will come out as 2. And what is your f of 4? F of 4, 4 is an even number. So f of 4 will be 4 by 2. 4 by 2 is also equal to 2. So we are getting f of 3 is equal to f of 4, but 3 cannot never be equal to 4. Therefore, f is not 1, 1. What type of function? This is a many one function. Now come to the onto properties. By onto properties, we have to consider any element from what? Any element from the codomain. Let y belongs to the codomain n be any element. What is your procedure? Such that f of n is equal to f of n is equal to y. So what is your y? That therefore y is equal to, y is nothing but your this function, that is n plus 1 by 2 when n is odd and n by 2 when n is even. So this is y in terms of n. We have to convert n in terms of y. So from the first line, what will be your n? N is equal to twice y minus 1. So n is twice y minus 1 when n is odd, and n is equal to twice y when n is even. So in both case, n is equal to twice y minus 1 or n equal to twice y, in both case n belongs to n. N will be a natural number. Therefore, for every y belongs to n, that is codomain, we will get a point in the domain n such that f of n is equal to y. Therefore, f is an onto function. This is only onto, therefore this is a surjective function. This is the example of a surjective function. Now come to our third example. Third example says that f is a function from R to R defined as fx is equal to minus 1 for x less than 0, fx equal to 0 when x is equal to 0, and here it is n equal to 0 written, it should be x is equal to 0, right? And it is 1 fx is equal to 1 for x is greater than 1, for every x belongs to 1. Now you see here, what is that function? You have already got this type of functions in your HS first year course. This is a, what type of function? This is a signum function. Right, signum function, that is your mod x by x. Now you see here, we have to check whether this function is bijective or not. Now you see here, f of 1, that is for every positive value of x, your fx is nothing but your 1. So if I consider f of 1, it will be 1, f of 2, it will be 2. So f of 1 is equal to f of 2, but 1 is not equal to 2. So the function is not 1, 1. It is an example of an whatever function, many one function. Because all the negative terms, image of all negative terms will be equal to your minus 1. Image of 0 is nothing but your 0, and image of all positive terms is nothing but your 1. Achha. Now you see here, this function is not 1, 1. Second one is, what is the range of a function? Minus 1, 0 and plus 1. Now, what is your codomain? Codomain is nothing but your R. So, in R, there are so many numbers x. So many numbers are there. That is minus 2, minus 3, plus 1, plus 2. So many numbers are there. Now, you see here, there are so many elements left which are not the image of any elements of its domain R. Therefore, clearly, f is not an onto function. Whatever function, this is an into function. Right? So, this is not a bijective function, right? If your questions come, that is when check whether it is bijective. From here also, that is, since f is not 1, 1, from this line we can say that f is not bijective. No need to check the onto properties in that case, if such type of question comes in the exam, right? No need to check the onto properties. Since it is not 1, 1, from this line we can clearly say that this is not bijective. So there are so many examples given in the book. You please go through the book and try to solve this type of problems. I hope you can do it. That's all for today. Thank you, everybody.